to my channel, Ancient Narratives from Vedic Legends Lounge. We will continue with the glories of Chapter 8, Akshara Parabrahma Yoga. Attaining the Supreme, of the Bhagavad Gita from Padma Purana, Bhava Sharman's story. This story corresponds to Chapter 182 of the Book 6, Uttarakhanda, of the Padma Purana. Before we continue, please subscribe to my channel for more spiritual content and glories of other chapters of Bhagavad Gita from Padma Purana. For Bhagavad Gita Mahatya, stories of other chapters, links are given in the description. Please watch the complete video. Lord Shiva said, "My dear Parvati, now please listen to the glories of the 8th chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. After listening to this, you will feel great joy." In the south is an important town of the name Amarthakapur, in which one Brahmana of the name Bhava Sharma lived, who had taken a prostitute as his wife. Bhava Sharma enjoyed eating meat, drinking wine, stealing, going with others' wives, and hunting. One day, that sinful Bhava Sharma was invited to a party, where he drank so much alcohol that it started to come out of his mouth. After the party, he became very sick and suffered from chronic dysentery, and after many days of suffering he died and attained the body of a date palm tree. One day, two Brahma Rakshasas, ghosts came and took shelter under that tree. Their previous life story was as follows. There was a Brahmana by the name of Kushibal, who was very learned in the Vedas and had studied all branches of knowledge. His wife's name was Kumati, who was very evil-minded. Although that Brahmana was very learned, he was also very greedy. Along with his wife, he used to collect lots of charity every day, but he would never give charity to any other Brahmana. When their time came to die, they both attained the forms of Brahma Rakshasas. As Brahma Rakshasas, they continuously wandered here and there over the earth, suffering from hunger and thirst. One day they rested under that date palm tree. At that time, the wife inquired from the husband, "How can we get free from this curse of being Brahma Rakshasas?" He replied, "By knowledge of Brahma, by knowledge of the self, by knowledge of fruit of activities. Without such knowledge, it is not possible to get free from our sinful reactions." Upon hearing this, the wife inquired, "Oh, my lord, what is Brahma? What is the self? What are fruit of activities? Kim tad Brahma kim adhyatmam kim karma purushottama?" Completely by accident. The wife happened to chant half of the first shloka of the 8th chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. At that time, having heard that half shloka, Bhava Sharma broke free from that form as a tree and again attained a body of a Brahmana, completely free from all sin. Suddenly from the sky came a flower airplane, which took that husband and wife back home, back to Godhead, Vaikuntha. Afterwards, that Brahmana, Bhava Sharma, with great respect, wrote down that half shloka, "Kim tad Brahma, kim adhyatmam, kim karma purushottama," and with the intention of worshipping Lord Krishna. He went to Kashipuri and started performing great austerities while continuously chanting that half shloka. Meanwhile in Vaikuntha, Lakshmi, seeing Lord Vishnu, had risen suddenly from taking rest, inquired with folded hands, "Why have you risen so suddenly from your sleep?" Lord Vishnu said, "My dear Lakshmi, in Kashipuri, on the bank of the river Ganges, my devotee is performing great austerities, continuously chanting half a shloka of the 8th chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. For a long time I have been thinking how to award his devotion." Parvati inquired from Lord Shiva, "When Lord Vishnu was so pleased with his devotee, what benediction did he bestow upon him?" Lord Shiva said, "Bhava Sharma went to Vaikuntha to engage in the eternal service of the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu. Not only that, but all of his ancestors also attained the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu." My dear Parvati, I have narrated, though you just, a little of the glories of the 8th chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Thank you. Thank you for joining on this devotional journey. If you enjoyed this story, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel, Ancient Narratives from Vedic Legends Lounge. For more spiritual content and glories of other chapters of Bhagavad Gita from Padma Purana.